So in this video, we're going to look at blood sugar homeostasis and its negative feedback loop. So when we talk about blood sugar remaining balanced, our body works very hard to keep everything in homeostasis. And so after a meal, when our blood sugar increases, we call that a stimulus. So it causes a response within our body. So our pancreas, in response to the increase in blood sugar, is going to release a hormone. That hormone will travel through our bloodstream to our liver and muscle cells. That hormone is called insulin. So insulin will target the cells in the liver, and it will tell the liver cells to take the blood sugar out of our blood and store it. Now, this is what returns our blood sugar back to homeostasis. Then over time, if our blood sugar drops, then or decreases, then our pancreas is going to release an opposite hormone of insulin. It's going to tell our liver cells that we need to send that sugar back into our bloodstream. So that hormone is called glucagon. And once glucagon reaches the liver will send that sugar it was storing back into the blood to bring us back to homeostasis. So we call this process a negative feedback loop. Now, the reason it's called a negative feedback loop is because over here, when the blood sugar rises, it brings us away from homeostasis, and we want to make that that difference, we want to make it more negative. So we want to bring it back. So we want to make that extreme more negative and bring us back to homeostasis. Now, on the same note, when the blood sugar decreases, that stimulus brings us away from homeostasis. So we want to reduce that, right? We want to make it more negative and bring it back to homeostasis. So here we have a negative feedback loop of how our endocrine system works with our circulatory system in order to bring us back to balance and try and keep us in blood sugar homeostasis.